Welcome to another exciting video by Pristine Tech School. My name is Harpreet and today we will be doing abstract class in C++ programming language. So, abstract class is a class which contains at least one pure virtual function in it. Abstract classes are used to provide an interface for its subclasses. Classes inheriting the abstract class must provide definition to the pure virtual function, otherwise they will also become abstract class. So, there are some characteristics of abstract class that abstract class cannot be instantiated, but pointers and references of abstract class type can be created. Second thing, abstract class can have normal functions and variables along with the pure virtual function. Third one, that classes, abstract classes are mainly used for upcasting so that its derived classes can use its interface. And the last one is that classes inheriting an abstract class must implement all pure virtual functions or else they will become abstract too. So now, what are pure virtual functions? Pure virtual functions are virtual functions with no definition. They start with a virtual keyword and ends with equal to zero. So it's like if we are creating pure virtual function, we going to create like this. Virtual, any function like display equals to zero. So this is how we going to create the pure virtual function. We are calling it pure. But it doesn't mean that we have to use the keyword pure, because pure is not any keyword and we are not going to use that. If we have to create any pure virtual function, we simply doing this. Like this. Virtual void display equal to 0. Equal to 0 means that we have to get that this is a pure virtual function. Now let's start with the example. Like I'm creating the example. First include the header files. Now, I'm creating class with the name of bank. In this class, I'm going to create one virtual function like R, like this, rate of interest. Rate of interest. That is equal to 0. So like bank is providing the rate of interest, so we have created the body. Now in next class, I am creating the class with the name of PNB that inherited, that is inheriting the bank class. So in this class, we are going to do the use of abstract class pure virtual function, that is void rate of interest so like this is giving me PNB is providing rate of interest equals to say 10%. Similarly, I'm going to create other classes like other banks like RBI that also inheriting the base class, that is abstract class bank. So here again I am going to use that virtual function void rate of interest. So like this, RBI bank is providing rate of interest equals to say 12%. Now in main function what we do, we going to create the object of PNB like P and going to call the function, that is rate of interest. Now first let's see the output. Okay, so it's giving me the output that PNB is providing rate of interest 10%. So similarly, I have also created one more class, that is of RBI. So I'm going to create the object of RBI, that is R, and calling the rate of interest of that is provided by the RBI bank. So now let's see. Okay, now RBI is providing the rate of interest, that is 12%. Similarly, we are going to create other banks also like ICICI or HDFC. Like I am creating the class of HDFC bank that is inheriting the base class, that is bank. And similarly, using the abstract class function, that is void rate of interest, so this bank will provide some different rate of interest. Like 9%. Similarly, we are going to create the object of HDFC bank and calling the function. So now let's compile it. So now it's giving me the rate of interest that is provided by the HDFC bank. So this is all about abstract classes. In this example, base class is abstract with pure virtual function, that is rate of interest. You can see that rate of interest. Hence we cannot create the object of base class, but we are creating the object of other classes that are inheriting the base class, like these parent classes PNB, RBI and HDFC. So this is how we can deal with the abstract classes, pure virtual functions. So guys, frequently we are uploading various videos and you can refer that videos from our Facebook page as well as from blog, and that description is given below about the Facebook page and blog. And if you are having any follow-up question, you can let me know in the comment section below, and don't forget to hit like, share and subscribe button. Hit that little bell icon so that you're always notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you.